we're going to have to berate you every time you do anything less than a 70-foot kite leap now. You suck! Lately, I've been losing sleep.
Dreaming about the things that we could. Lewis, you just bought a kite leap. Where are your foot? What was the technique with landing? We go for the left cheek or the right cheek? Okay, just trying not to die. Solid. Yeah, we'll be counting stars.
Swing my heart across the line. In my face is flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told.
Makes me feel alive. Baby, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard, said no more counting dollars.
I hope you enjoyed that video, guys. That is Taming the Beast by Push Kiting. Lewis got rather close on this jump, didn't he? Let me move out of the way. The beast from the east brought the really strong easterly winds, and that is exactly what we need to be looping a 7 meter. I wouldn't advise learning to loop a kite on the land. Start on the water first and start gently. I mean, come to us at Push Kiting School if you want to learn how to do a kite loop safely. But yeah, doing a 7 meter kite loop is tricky because it goes around really quick and then the kite wants to whip away from you and go out of the power zone and you can just drop like a stone to the floor. So you've got to be careful you get it right. But when you do get it right, it's awesome fun. And it's even better when you've got your friends with you. So we had Lewis Wilby, AJ Phillipson, Chris Beach and myself, David Ursell. And we had an awesome time. So it's great to get the whole crew together. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe. Check out the other video and that website too for our school. You can come along, have some lessons if you want to loop safely, or you just want to learn to kite surf at all or kite landboard. Okay, take care guys, bye.